day of rotations. Okay? And you're going to have to kind of put your think out of the box cap on, visualizing this with me, because not a real good draw artist. I think you know that by now. Maybe some of you think I am, but I don't think so. So today what we're going to do is I'm going to show you visually what these types of problems are about, and then hopefully we can kind of get a feel for how to do the process by looking at it. Okay? So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to use our very common y equals x squared graph.
Uh-huh.
Okay? But I want to use y equals x squared only from, let's say, 0 to 4. Okay, so what does it look like when it goes from 0 to 4?
It looks like just like a little piece, like a little string.
A little piece of it, right?
Yeah.
So let's say this is 0, let's say this is 4, okay?
We restricted its domain.
We restricted its domain, that's exactly right. So we've taken this thing and we've restricted its domain. Everybody good so far?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to start taking an axis, whether it is an x-axis or whether it's a y-axis. And we're going to take this chunk that I have drawn here,
uh-huh,
okay, and we're going to rotate it about an axis. So literally, we're going to take it and we're going to start, I'll do this one first. We're going to rotate it, in this case, about the x-axis.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so visualize that this piece on the bottom is fixed. In other words, it's touching that. It won't pick it up. It won't move. It's fixed to that spot. And it starts to take this thing, and it starts to revolve it and go around and then go back through the board and come back up. And it just keeps revolving, revolving. It doesn't move up and down this way. It just stays steady, and it just rotates around it. Okay?
Yeah.
Kind of like when you're laying under a fan. Some of you may have never done this. When you lay under a fan and you stare at the blades, what happens to the blades eventually if you stare long enough?
They slow down.
They what?
They slow down.
They slow down? But do they kind of look solid almost? Like they become one blade almost? If you look at it long enough, try it. So if you look at it long enough, it kind of visualizes, it kind of feels as if it's, yeah.
Because it's going so fast.
That,
right?
It looks like it's one blade doing its thing.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, have fun. So what we're going to do is we're going to rotate this thing. Visually, what would it look like? Well, it starts to come around, and it looks a bit like that. So in my perspective, I'm going to give you what I think it looks like. It looks like a Hershey's chocolate laying on its side. Can you visualize that now? Yes.
So why did it make that shape like it did? Because I understand, like, you know, when it's going up like this, and then now it's like this, but where did you get the line that vertical line?
This guy here?
Yeah.
Well, this is going to be the end of whatever, because I'm only going to 4. So this is kind of like, it could be considered hollow because there's really nothing in there. But let's say there's an imaginary line. And as that thing starts to rotate, that imaginary line completes itself down here.
Should we always draw that imaginary line?
Yeah, it would help you.
Yeah.
Okay. So, does everybody see a piece of Hershey's Kiss laying on its side?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you guys agree with me. Like, if I take that Hershey Kiss off right now and I held it up to you, what would you see in front of you? Like, I took it off. Here it is right in front of you. What would you see?
A Hershey's Kiss?
No, I'm taking it off. Yes. I'm taking it off, and this little part is pointing at me. So the little piece is at me. You see a circle. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah?
You got to think three-dimensionally.
You got to think three-dimensional. So here it is. It's my Hershey's Kiss. I should have brought a Hershey's Kiss in. That would have been very helpful, you know? So a Hershey's Kiss, you guys agree, looks like that.
Mm-hmm.
But at the bottom, don't you agree, it's kind of a rounded aspect of it. If you actually have ever eaten a Hershey's Kiss and you pick it up and look at it, you're like, oh, yeah, it's round. Does that make sense?
Many,
a few of them. One or two. Me too. I like the ones you get around Valentine's Day.
They're really good.
Yeah. So, I'm just kidding. You know, I can't do it. I wish I could. So here we are. And so if I take it and lift it like that, what you see in front of you, I think you guys see it, is a round circle. Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say I'm going to take this piece and cut it here. And then I take that Hershey Kiss and hold it to you. What do you see? So in other words, I took this and cut it like right down here, and then I'd pick it up and show you.
It's a smaller circle?
It's a smaller circle, right? Are you good with that, right? Okay, what happens if I decide to cut it right here and pick it up and show you?
Even smaller.
Again, smaller circle, right? Continue with that process over here, and then, and I could do it all the way, right?
Yep.
You guys agree with me?
Yeah.
Okay. So, everybody cool with how we see a circle? That's like the most important part of this.
Okay.
So far, so good. Everybody understanding that? Okay, so to find the volume of something by rotation, you're going to use a formula. The formula is the integral from A to B. What is A and B again?
Like your wall to wall.
My wall to wall, right? My left to right, my X, right? Okay, so it's going to be A to B, and it's going to be pi r squared. Yes.
So you're going to take the integral of r squared, and pi goes for the ride?
And pi goes for the ride.
But
what
for,
is pi r squared, by the way?
That's the
area
of a circle.
Area of a circle, yes.
But you're going to have an actual value for r, right?
Yeah, we'll talk about that.
Because, yeah.
Yeah, we'll have an actual value for r. I'll explain what that means, what it all means. But let's dissect this for a minute. So we have pi r squared, you guys told me it's area of a circle, right?
Yes.
What is r in reference of a circle?
The radius.
Radius of the circle. Literally, what does radius of a circle mean?
Half of the diameter.
Half of the diameter, half that circle, right? So if I'm looking at this thing, and I start to rotate this puppy around, let's say I'm going to take this blue line right here, right? And I start to rotate that guy around, right? Would you agree that that blue line would extend itself and it would actually be like the whole diameter, of a circle if I was rotating it? Okay. So in actuality, what is the blue line in reference to this thing? Well, it's actually a radius of a circle. Does that make sense? Okay. Okay, so let's look at another one. Here to here. Okay. Remember I cut it and I kept showing you that thing? You told me it was a smaller circle, a smaller circle, right? Okay, so what would this red line be? It would be a radius of another circle that's in there, right?
But it's the larger circle,
it's
so
larger,
it's
a larger circle, right? So if I keep going,
smaller
circle. Circle radius, right? So what happens if I continue into a million, trillion, infinitely many little lines here, and I say, okay, let's find the actual area of each of these little sliced circles that we come up with. So if I find the area of this, plus the area of the next one, plus the area of the next one, and I do an infinite number of circles, what would I end up getting?
The area of the whole thing.
It would actually, I'd get the area of each of the individual pieces. What happens if I add all those areas together?
The whole thing.
I get the volume.
Or, you get the volume.
I do.
Yeah.
I would get the volume. Because really, what is the volume of something?
For?
Like, if I think of a can on the floor, like the area of the base times the height, right? So it's that little circle that's on the floor and then every sliced circle above it added together with how high it is. Does that make sense visually? So every sliced circle here, area, add them up, I get the volume of my Hershey's Kiss. What this is going to do for me is it's actually going to give me a formula where I don't have to find the area of the little green circle and the blue circle and the red circle. I can find the area of the generic circle, and I can take the integral from wall to wall, and I have the volume of it. It's a really kind of a cool concept, yes.
But how do you know which radius to use? Because
that's a really good question.
Because there you have several radiuses of different sizes, because that was at where the circle was smaller and when it was also bigger.
So let's look at what the common thing of every single one of those are. So the radius of them. What is the common thing of every single one of them? Where do they start and where do they end as far as the radius is concerned? They start on this curve, right?
And they hit the x-axis.
And they hit the x-axis. You guys agree with me? So the radius of this is whatever the point at that line is, minus zero, whatever point, et cetera, et cetera.
Uh-huh.
So truly, what is the radius of every single circle that we're referring to here? What is the radius of any of those in reference to? It's actually x squared.
Right.
Right? Minus zero.
Because it's a ceiling minus floor.
Does that look familiar? So what is my radius? Ceiling minus floor. Really, that's all it is.
So x squared minus zero squared.
Mm-hmm. So let's do that. So we have pi. Pi from A to B. What's A? What's B?
Your A is zero and 4, 0 and
why
4.
Why 0 to 4? Because that's what I told you we're going with, right?
Yeah.
I could go from 0 to 2. I could go from 0 to 18. It just depends on how big I want that Hershey's Kiss, right?
Yeah.
So from 0 to 4. And then what was my radius? My radius is x squared. My floor is 0. Doesn't matter, right?
Right.
Keep that in mind, though. So really it's x squared minus 0. And then square it. Don't forget dx. Because dx sounds like I can integrate. Let's clean her up a little bit algebraically. What do I get? 0 to 4. X squared minus 0 is just x squared. X squared squared is what?
X to the 4th.
Yep. Can I integrate it now?
Yep.
Let's do it. X to the 5th.
Over 5.
From 0 to 4. Don't forget pi. Who would?
So now you're going to have pi times 4 to the 5th over 5 minus pi times 0 to the 5th over 5.
And you know what? You could just do pi in the very outside and distribute through, or do like you just said.
Yeah.
So 0 to the 5th over 5. And so the 0 doesn't really matter, but
right. Don't
be complacent because it could.
Yeah.
And so 4 to the 5th is a really big number I'm scared of.
It's 1,024.
That's a big number. Over 5, pi, there's the area. Yes.
So, like what will they give you, like, for the questions? Like, what information are they going to give you?
They give you the ceiling by picture, usually. The floor by picture, usually. Sometimes they'll tell you from A to B, they'll give you X and X. Sometimes they won't. How do we handle that? We set them equal to each other.
Well, but, so you set, like, you'll have two equations, and since they intersect, you set them equal to each other?
Right. It's the same kind of process we did yesterday with the area test, except for we're now just using a different formula for it.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
So that number represents the volume of that door three-dimensional figure that was spinning.
Isn't that cool?
Apparently.
I know. Okay. As cool as it's going to be. Okay. So here's the thing. When we start rotating things, you guys visually were cool with the, you were cool with that, right? Okay, does that make sense? You were cool with what it looks like a Hershey's Kiss.
Yes.
But there's multiple different places that we could potentially rotate. Let's look at what it could look like if we start rotating. And I'm just going to use x squared only for now, just because we know what x squared looks like to begin with. But let's just kind of visualize what everything looks like. Once again, we're using x squared and, I'll just go from 0 to 2, okay? So there's my x squared graph. What happens if I tell you to rotate about the line x equals 2? What would that look like?
You just kind of...
So this is my hinge, in other words.
That's the axis at which you're rotating it about.
Yeah, so it would come down the other way, right? Yeah, it would kind of shoop like that. That's my axis of rotation. Okay, so it would go... like that. So my Hershey's Kiss would be upright. Okay, does everybody see that?
That's for x equals 2?
That's if I'm rotating around x equals 2. Okay. Another type of rotation. Again, y equals x squared.
Yes.
Okay. Let's say I want to rotate about the y-axis.
Then it's just going to be kind of like that.
Yeah, it hinges right here. Would you agree?
Yep.
Hinges right here, so therefore, okay, it looks like that.
That's a bowl.
Yeah, it's called a bowl with a hole. You got it. That's what it is. Okay, it's a bowl. Say again. X squared. We're always using x squared. I just want you to see. Yes.
And you drew the lines down to indicate that that where the lines hit the x axis are your wall to walls, your a and your b's, your x values.
Mm-hmm. Now, talk to me a little bit. Let's kind of reason through this one. You guys agree, solid piece of chocolate, one I'd want to eat, right? Good stuff.
Uh-huh.
Full chocolate. What about this?
Same.
Solid chocolate, right?
Yeah.
What about this?
A bowl.
It's a bowl, but is it solid? It's solid here around, but this is definitely a hole, right? Does that make sense? Are you guys with me when I say that? Yes.
Well, how do we know for sure? Like, how could you make that conclusion? Like,
well, because as this solid wall, this solid space starts to rotate, this is all empty because it's not part of my graph.
Right, because whereas the other one, Yeah, it's like in the inside, but here we're caring about like the outside of it. Yeah.
Right, so does that make sense? Okay. So let's do another one. I want to rotate this guy around y equals negative 1. What would be my hinge would be here. Right here.
Okay.
So what would that look like? So my hinge is here. Yeah.
But just the hinge doesn't have to be at the point where it's already at.
Touching.
Well, but it would just be, there would be space in between them.
Mm-hmm. So it's a volcano-ish, right? So literally it comes down by the same amount. It comes there. I'm not going to be pretty. And it rotates, and I have a big old hole here, almost like a spaceship, right? Yeah, that's awesome.
Hmm.
You guys can't quite see what's happening, but the space happens up through here. Once again, that space, like I could put my arm through it, right? That space, is that part of the volume?
No.
So we have a dilemma. Because this is a full-on volume. This is a full-on volume. This one, not quite, okay? This one, not quite, because there's a hole. So you see the difference between. There's two different types of formulas, okay? This first one that I introduced to you is what we call the disk method. Okay? The disk method. The disk method kind of reminds me of a bit of like a hockey puck that's solid piece of something, okay? So when you start cutting the slices and you hold up that circle, you see just a full circle. It's a solid piece of chocolate, right? The other method that I want to talk about is what we call the washer method. A washer in reference to construction. What's a washer look like? Not like a...
Yeah.
It's like a silver ring, right?
It's hollow in the middle.
Yeah. I kind of refer to it as the donut.
Yeah.
What does a donut look like?
Hole in the middle.
A hole in the middle. Did somebody say donut?
Yeah.
See, you were on the same page. We got a solid piece of chocolate going on here, and we got a donut going on, right? So, what's that? I'm always hungry. Are you kidding?
So that's like donut holes, then that's the donut.
This, yeah, that's a good way to look at it. So there's my washer method. Okay, now when I'm talking about counting calories, right? Yeah, obviously I do that. When I talk about counting calories, if I look at this thing, what do I want to look at? The calories happen here, right?
Right.
But if, do I count these guys?
No.
No, I would count the whole thing minus the whole. Because don't make me count calories that don't exist, right?
Uh-huh.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So as far as a volume is concerned, I got to be able to eliminate that hole.
Uh-huh.
Does that make sense? So the formula is, I better write it out.
O-R?
Yeah. Outer. Does
outer.
It have two T's? Or does that look like otter? Outer radius squared minus inner radius. Squared. Okay? Outer radius squared minus inner radius squared. Let's look at my donut picture up here as an example. My outer radius, I think you would agree, goes from the top of the donut to the very center. Does that make sense? That's the whole radius. The radius from top to middle. My inner radius is this stuff right here. Do I want to count that as part of my calories, as part of my volume, as part of whatever? No, because this really doesn't exist, right? It's the whole. So it's the outer radius, green squared, minus the inner radius squared. So let's look at this sideways volcano here for a second, okay? What would my outer radius be? So my outer radius would start at the top of this, right? And go all the way down to the bottom, it goes down to the negative 1, right? So it goes from here down to here. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
How come it doesn't go from the highest point?
How come it doesn't go from, well, remember, the highest point, remember how I had green, blue, red?
Yes.
And any of those were referenced by x squared?
Yes.
Same concept here. Any of those will be referenced by X squared.
But, like, will they tell you which ones to look at? Like, they'll say right here which radius to look at?
No, because you're going to use X squared.
You're just going to use the function, right?
You don't use the actual radius. You use X radius squared. In relation to...
to the ceiling.
Right. Mm-hmm. The ceiling minus 4.
Yeah. So this is ceiling minus 4. Here's the 4.
Right.
Right? Now, what's the 4 that we don't want to worry about now? It's this one here.
So
that's
we...
gone. So that's my inner radius squared.
That's what we subtract.
Mm-hmm. They'll give us these numbers.
They will. So let's do this one.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to say that the original problem here was y equals x squared, and we're going to go from 0 to 2. I'm going to give you the wall to wall.
Uh-huh.
Okay? Yes. Everybody so far so good?
Yes.
Okay. So if I'm doing this, I'm going to go the integral, don't forget our pi, from 0 to 2.
Yes.
Are we okay? Yeah. And so where is the purple line hitting? The purple line is hitting x squared.
Yes.
Where is the purple line hitting down here?
Negative 1.
Negative 1. So, it's x squared ceiling minus 4.
X squared plus 1.
X squared plus 1, right?
Minus a negative.
So x squared minus negative 1 squared, that's the outer radius.
Right.
Minus the inner radius. What's the inner radius?
0 plus 1.
0 minus negative 1, right? So 0 minus negative 1 squared. And dx tells me I should be able to do the integral. Yes.
Wait, so it's ceiling minus floor, so that's the x squared minus 1.
Yeah. That's the outer radius. And then the inner radius is pink line. 0 minus negative 1.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So now we have some math magic to do. We have a little bit of algebra to do, clean her up a little bit, and then integrate. So we're going to do a lot of algebra here. This is x squared plus 1. You agree? And this square tells me to do what to it?
X to the 4th plus 1.
No.
Or
you would have to
foil
it out, right?
Oh, right.
Say it. I would foil it out because it's squared. I would use this because you have an x. Yeah, I would foil it out. Okay, so we have x to the 4th plus 2x squared plus 1. I can't help you. I'm working. And then we have positive 1 squared, right? So minus 1. Happens a lot.
So just x to the 4th plus 2x squared is what we're handling.
Right. Then what do? We integrate it.
X to the 5th over 5 plus 2x cubed over 3.
Bless you.
Thank you.
And I don't need a C.
Because you have an A to B.
Don't forget pi goes for the ride.
Mm-hmm.
So if I plug in the 2, I get 2 to the 5th over 5, right? And then plus 2 times 2 to the 3rd over 3. And what happens when I plug in the 0? It just zeroes out, right?
Yeah.
So don't forget your pi. I mean, you could put minus 0 just for fun. So what do we have? 32 fifths plus 16 thirds. You could probably have to use your little calculators for that. And you have your volume of that sideways volcano.
Then 16 pi, right?
What is it?
16 pi, right? Yeah.
Well, I'm getting a common denominator of 5 times 16 is 80. Thanks. So it's 176 over 15 pi. And 6 is 14. That doesn't divide by 3, so maybe that's it. So far. Yes.
So is it okay to leave it as a decimal or they want
yeah.
Well, they say, like, in terms of pi.
A lot of times they'll say, show that the volume of this is 8 pi, and they have the answer.
Okay, yeah.
So, or find the volume of rotation. Yeah.
So, what are the other graph, like equal line or curve that it could give us?
Anything. We're going to do some problems. But, let me give you a little chart. Okay, that's the chart that I never made. Alrighty, here it is. So far, do you notice that every single one of my rotations have been a horizontal rotation? Does that make sense what I'm trying to say?
Mm-hmm.
It rotates this way. The ones that we've done for problems, I mean. So the ones that we've accomplished have been this way. Yes.
What about the one that was outside?
But we didn't do that one yet, right? I didn't show you the work for that. This little thing helps a lot. So the disk method is the one I showed you. So we have disk and washer, two different methods. If I'm rotating horizontally, okay? If I'm rotating horizontally, everything is going to be in terms of dx.
Because it's when you're doing it over the x-axis.
You're going around the x-axis.
Or the line y equals negative 1. Or,
right.
Yeah.
Everything is going to be in that aspect. If I'm doing it vertically, okay, everything must be in terms of dy.
Okay. Yeah.
So that changes things a little. Okay? I always say, when you're going vertically, when you're going to have a party, right? When you're having, I think it's fun. So when you're having a party, that's right. You're with me, you're having a party. Anything that goes around this way is going to have to be in terms of y. Everything must be in terms of y. Do you see it?
Because it's going around the y-axis.
Because it's going around anything that's revolving around a y-axis. Even if it says, like, revolved around x equals 2, you're still revolving that way.
It's in that y direction.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
yeah.
So let's do one of those, and I'll show you how that changes things up a little bit. Now, I've seen one time on an ACE exam that they went around the y-axis.
Mostly it's x.
Mostly. So, okay. So, we're going to do my y equals x squared, and we're going to revolve around x equals 2. And so I want you to, we're going to have to, first I'll draw it. Huh? 0 to 2. 0 to 2. Sorry. Okay, so what does it look like? So it's from 0 to 2, x squared.
So, yeah.
Did you guys do your solid Hershey's Kiss that sits upright? Did you get that? Rotating around there. Everybody okay? Yeah, no, maybe so? Okay. So, now, when we're doing it, because we're having a party, because we're going around a dy axis, everything must be in terms of dy. Everything must be in terms of y. Okay? So right now, I'm going from 0 to 2, where x is 0, x is 2.
Yeah.
If I tell you everything must be in terms of y, you say, okay, when x is 0, what is y?
0.
0. How do you do that?
Because when you have x's...
You just plug it in here, right?
Yeah.
So when x is 0, y is 0. When x is 2, what was y?
4.
So now, my integral is going to go from 0 to 4 instead of 0 to 2. Why is it 0 to 4? Because everything must be in terms of, okay? Now, you guys were pretty good about doing ceiling minus 4. You guys see it from top to bottom, right? How the heck do you do it when it's sideways?
Wall minus wall.
Kind of, sort of, yeah. I always tell everybody, tilt your head to the right. I know, play the game with me. Tilt your head to the right, okay? We're going to start here. And we're going to go from here. Oh, we're not going to use that one, though, are we? That was a teaser. We're going to go from here to here. Do you agree that that's the radius of this thing now?
Yeah.
Yeah. If you tilt your head, you see it. So if you're tilting your head, this thing goes around. That's now going to be the radius of the circle that I would cut and show you.
Uh-huh.
So if everything has to be in terms of, I want to know ceiling and floor here. Now, we're squaring it, so it doesn't really matter if you do this part first or this part first, because you're squaring it, it's going to give you the same thing, okay? So, do you agree that this line is known as 2?
X equals, yeah.
Yeah, so 2,
yeah.
Right? And what is this line known as?
X squared.
It's X squared, but it must be in terms of Y.
So, Y squared? No, it's Y.
Square root of y, right?
Solve for y in terms of x.
Right, right. So this minus this. Okay, once again, we're going to go from 0 to 4, and then our radius is now from here to here, because we're partying, right? We're going this way. And so it's going to be from 2 to square root of y, instead of x squared, because we can't have it in terms of x's. So this is going to be 2 minus the square root of y, and what do I need to do to it? I need to
square it,
because it's pi r squared. Don't forget the pi. Now you do the problem. Yes.
And you need to use the disk method, because this was something that was like a whole thing. Like, it wasn't hollow. It wasn't like separated.
Right.
Right.
Right. So we'll do the math on that one. Is the bell about to ring?
Yeah.
Yes.
Couple seconds. All right. So remind me tomorrow to start with the bowl with the hole. Bowl with the hole to show you integration. Okay?
Are we just
Just one more thing, and then we're going to try problems. So you can technically go home and try a couple of them. Your worksheet that you already have, they're already there. Yeah.
To be continued.